I'm Dr. Alex Danis with miniPCR Bio, and today I'm going to introduce you to one of the most common tools in the molecular biology lab, the micropipette. Micropipettes allow us to accurately measure very small volumes. Becoming comfortable with using micropipettes will allow you to tackle a range of experiments in the molecular biology lab. Today, we're going to be using pipettes from miniPCR Bio, but these instructions will apply to almost any micropipette. You will encounter four main sizes of pipettes: 1,000, 200, 20, and 10 microliters. These are very small volumes. A microliter is just a very tiny drop of liquid, only 1/1,000,000th of a liter. One of the most comfortable ways to hold a pipette is like this, with the pipette resting in your palm and the finger rest positioned over your index finger. This allows your thumb to comfortably control both the plunger and the ejection button. You should first make sure that you select the appropriate pipette for the volume you need to measure. For example, the 20 microliter pipette will accurately measure volumes between 2 and 20 microliters. Trying to use a pipette at a volume outside of its range will result in inaccurate measurements and may damage the pipette. Let's look at our 20 microliter pipette. There are three digits displayed here. The top digit is the tens place, the second digit is the ones place, and the third digit is tenths. To set the volume of your pipette, carefully turn the top or side dial. If you wanted to pipette 15 microliters, you would turn the dial so that the numbers looked like this, with a 1 in the tens place, a 5 in the ones place, and a 0 in the decimal place. Alternatively, setting it for 5.5 microliters would look like this. The other sizes of pipettes are set in just the same way, but make sure you take into account that the digits places may be different on different sizes and models of pipettes. For example, on this 200 microliter pipette, the first digit is the hundreds place, then the tens, then the ones with hash marks for the decimal place. Setting the 200 microliter pipette for 125 microliters would look like this. Alternatively, setting the 1000 microliter pipette for the same 125 microliter volume would look like this, because the first digit is the thousands place, then the hundreds, then the tens, with dash marks for the ones. Once you have set the volume on your pipette, you will need to add a pipette tip. Tips prevent liquid from entering the main body of the pipette, keeping it clean. You should change tips every time you pipette a new sample or reagent in order to prevent contamination. If your pipette tips come in a loose bag, you will want to carefully pick a tip up by the sides and slide it firmly onto your pipette. If your tips are provided in a rack, firmly tap your pipette into one of the tips to secure it to the end. Always make sure that you are using the correct size tip for your pipette. With both methods, make sure the tip is firmly attached, and make sure to always use a tip. Liquid should never enter the main body of the pipette. To dispose of a tip, press down on the ejection button over a waste container. There are two stops on the pipette plunger. When you press down, you will feel a moment of resistance before you push the plunger all the way down. This is called the first stop. Practice pressing the plunger down to just this first stop a few times. Now, push the plunger down all the way to the bottom to the second stop. You should practice stopping at each of these points a few times before pipetting. To draw liquid into the pipette, push the plunger down to the first stop. Then, place the pipette tip into the liquid and release the plunger slowly. This will draw the correct volume of liquid into your tip. To dispense into a new tube, touch the pipette tip to the bottom or side wall of the tube and push the plunger down past the first stop until you feel the second stop. Pull your pipette tip away before releasing the plunger to ensure that the liquid is not drawn back up into the pipette. If the tube already has liquid in it, make sure the tip of your pipette is touching that liquid before you dispense the volume in the pipette to ensure proper mixing. By making sure the pipette tip is touching either the side of the tube or another liquid before pipetting, you can prevent small droplets from sticking to the pipette tip. It can be helpful to hold the tube up to eye level so that you can see exactly where you are dispensing the liquid. Once you're done, remember to eject your tip and put on a new one before your next step. If you need to mix a solution by pipetting, place the tip into the liquid. Carefully release and push the plunger back down to only the first stop several times, with the tip remaining in the liquid to mix. To avoid getting bubbles in your solution when mixing, make sure to pipette up and down slowly and don't press the plunger past the first stop. When done mixing, press the plunger to the second stop and remove the pipette tip from the liquid like you normally would. If you do accidentally create bubbles, The liquid can be returned to the bottom of the tube by gently shaking the tube or by spinning briefly in a centrifuge. And it's as easy as that. Once you've mastered these skills, you'll feel confident setting up reactions, running gels, and exploring more experiments in the biology lab. To view pipetting practice activities and learn more about the kinds of experiments you can do with your new pipetting skills, you can visit miniPCR.com/micropipetting.